This song is not for you. If you've never cried a river or had your heart broken too, this song is not for you. If every day you wake up, the skies are blue.
Discovery Kids Zone. Welcome to a special edition of Discovery Kids Zone, where we stop and pause to pay tribute and honor to the great soldier of civil rights, Martin Luther King Jr. But before we get started, let's bow our head for a moment of prayer.
Let us pray for each other and for peace for all. God, transform us and create us anew. Help us be the nonviolent peacemakers your world needs. We rely on you to fill us with strength, grace, and guidance as we struggle and brave love, as we suffer willingly to the day when all people will know your true peace and justice. Work through us, Holy Spirit, and help us to be the vibrant in our faith and hope in you. We pray this through Jesus Christ, the Prince of Peace. Amen.
Amen.
Now, in honor of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., let's sing a song of tribute for his life and contribution to our society as a mighty man of God.
Yeah, yeah. Hey everybody, let me talk about Dr. Martin Luther King. He fought for equality and letting freedom ring. Dr. King, a truly great man and a leader for civil rights, fought against prejudice every day and night.
Break it down now.
Dr. King, Dr. King, Martin Luther King. Dr. King, Dr. King, Martin Luther King.
He went to the mountaintop and said he had a dream where every man had equal rights and opportunities.
Yeah.
He made a commitment to us all with true determination. Told the world he would help us end all segregation. Washington in 1963,
D.C.,
standing up for love and truth, justice was his plea. He made a huge difference for all of us, you see, for now we all know the true meaning of liberty. Yeah.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. had a dream that one day we would be judged not by the color of our skin, but by the content of our character.
Martin Luther King Jr. was born on January 15, 1929 in Atlanta, Georgia. He graduated from Morehouse College in 1948 and was ordained as a Baptist minister. While studying theology at Crozer Seminary in Chester, Pennsylvania, King attended a lecture of Mahatma Gandhi's Nonviolent Struggle for Freedom for the People of India. Gandhi's teachings had a profound effect on the young Baptist minister. Upon graduation, King received a scholarship to pursue a doctoral degree at Boston University. There he met Coretta Scott, who was studying voice at the Boston Conservatory of Music. The two were married in 1953. They had four children. King's involvement in nonviolent protests began in 1955 in Montgomery, Alabama, where he led a successful boycott of the city's buses. Over the next 13 years, he promoted nonviolence as a means for African Americans to achieve their civil rights and was jailed several times. King also helped the Southern Christian Leadership Conference in 1957. Internationally, he was viewed as an eloquent and forceful proponent of nonviolence. Among other prizes and awards given to him, King was honored with the Nobel Peace Prize in 1964. 4 years later, at the age of 39, he was assassinated in Memphis, Tennessee. King's birthday is January 15th, and we celebrate it on Monday as a national holiday.
Bye.
Martin Luther King had a dream that one day there would be equality and unity among all races. A Bible verse that affirms this is a selfless Good Samaritan that is bold and courageous and extends his hand to help someone who looks different and is from a different place. We should love our neighbors as ourselves. Loving our neighbor as ourselves is one of the two great commandments. According to Jesus, Matt 22:39, racism always insults our brothers and sisters and causes us to commit murder in our hearts. Racism has also tragically led to abuse and murder of millions of God's imagine bearers throughout history. Check out this video on Good Samaritans.
Once upon a time, there was a Jewish man on a dangerous journey. He was on his way to Jericho from Jerusalem. His journey took him through winding mountain passes and desert trails. It was beautiful but treacherous at the same time. This popular road was known through the region to be a hideout for robbers, who would many times attack and kill their victims. And that's exactly what happened to this poor man. He was riding nervously and quietly through the pass when suddenly a group of robbers jumped from the rocks and surrounded him. They rushed toward him, knocked him down, beat him up, and stole all his possessions. Snickering with glee, they ran away to their secret hideout. They left the man to die in the withering desert sun. This was a popular road, so the robbers knew more victims would be traveling this road. For them, this meant more robbing and stealing. The man lay there dying, praying that someone would come and rescue him. He heard the muttering of prayers and pious language. A priest was coming and would rescue him. But as the priest came into sight, he did something strange. He pretended to not even see the injured man. In fact, he passed by on the other side of the road. Then, as the injured man was losing hope, he was awoken by the sound of footsteps. He lifted his head and saw another man journeying through the mountain pass. This man was a temple assistant. Finally, a rescuer! Imagine the man's grief when this man, too, passed right by him without so much as a sniff. Then something extraordinary happened. A despised Samaritan passed by the injured man. Samaritans were disliked by Jews, so the injured man knew that this Samaritan would most likely ignore him too. But to his surprise, the Samaritan came to his rescue. He cleaned the man's wounds, bandaged them up, put the man on his donkey, and helped him to the nearest town. There, he gave an innkeeper a generous amount of money to spend on the man to keep him well. "If I need to pay any more, just tell me when I get back," he told the innkeeper. Jesus told this parable to explain the importance of love. God is not interested in our worship or works if it is not filled with love. To truly worship God is to truly love your neighbor, even if it is someone you don't really like.
If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward.
And a part of moving forward is being a Good Samaritan. This was an idea and concept that MLK sacrificed his life in order for America and this entire world to realize. Being a good Samaritan is something that we should all strive to be, and it was something a part of MLK's bold vision of inclusivity. Now let's watch the CBS News report that explores his vision through his perspective of his grandchildren and children. Have a good day.
To honor the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. on this holiday, we are taking a close look at his inspiring words. The civil rights icon delivered the American Dream sermon at Ebenezer Baptist Church in Atlanta in 1965. We asked his children, Bernice and Martin Luther King III, and his granddaughter, Yolanda, to read part of it. They say his words are just as relevant today.
We shall not.
I would like to discuss some of the problems
that we confront in the world today.
And some of the problems that we confront in our own nation
by using as a subject the American dream.
I chose this subject because America is essentially a dream. It is a dream of a land where men of all races, of all nationalities, and of all creeds can live together as brothers.
The substance of the dream is expressed in these sublime words. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain inalienable rights.
That among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Now we notice in the very beginning that at the center of this dream is an amazing universalism.
It does not say some men, but it says all men. It does not say all white men, but it says all men, which includes black men.
Black and white together.
It does not say all Gentiles, but it says all men, which includes Jews. It does not say all Protestants, but it says all men, which includes Catholics.
That is something else that we notice in this American dream, which is one of the things that distinguishes our form of government with some of the other totalitarian systems.
It says that each individual has certain inherent rights that are neither derived from or conferred by the state.
There are gifts from the hands of the Almighty God.
Keep your eyes on the prize.
For the American dream reminds us that every man is the heir of a legacy of worthfulness.
We are not afraid.
But ever since the founding fathers of our nation dreamed this dream, America has been something of a schizophrenic personality.
On the one hand, we have proudly professed the noble principles of democracy. On the other hand, we have sadly practiced the very antithesis of those principles.
Indeed, slavery and segregation have been strange paradoxes.
In a nation founded on the principle that all men are created equal.
But now more than ever before, America is challenged to realize its noble dream, for the shape of the world today does not permit us the luxury of an anemic democracy.
And the price that the United States must pay for the continued exploitation and oppression of the Negro and other minority groups is the price of its own destruction.
So in a real sense, our hour is late. And the clock of destiny is ticking out.
We must act now before it is too late.
It is trite, but urgently true, that if America is to remain a first-class nation,
she can no longer have second-class citizens.
Well, all those years later, the word still holds up, gives you goosebumps.
Yes,
little Yolanda
sure
is 10. She's MLK the Third's daughter,
yeah,
named after his late sister Yolanda. She's something else, too.
She's got a great smile.
Yeah,
I love her
smile. She does. Very nicely done. Eliana Mintz.
As our producer did that.
It's hard to do that with no track.
In honor of MLK Day, I would like to read a poem by Langston Hughes entitled, I Too Sing America. I Too, by Langston Hughes. I Too Sing America. I am the darker brother. They send me eat in the kitchen when company comes. But I laugh and eat well and grow strong. Tomorrow, I'll be at the table when company comes. Nobody will dare say to me, eat in the kitchen then. Besides, they'll see how beautiful I am and be ashamed. I too am America.
Hello, everyone. This is Pastor Chris. What a wonderful, wonderful MLK presentation. I'm so proud of all of the folks at Discovery Zone that made this wonderful, wonderful tribute to Dr. Martin Luther King possible. So without further ado, let's close our eyes for a closing word of prayer. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you for another chance for allowing us just to be in your space, your place. We just appreciate you. We appreciate what you're doing. We appreciate the legacy that you have given us through the life and the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Help us to live our life as followers of you, but help us to use this great saint, this great man, as an example on how to be Christians and how to be model citizens. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I love you all. Until next time, signing out. It's been Discovery Zone Church, Martin Luther King Tribute.